I'm Nicole Webster, Chief Scientist at the Australian Antarctic Division. My background is in marine microbiology, so I work on the tiny little things that live in the ocean that actually have a really large impact. So a really critical component of the marine environment that's frequently overlooked. Bacteria, archaea, even viruses that can infect bacteria. So microbes are a really sensitive indicator for the ecosystem health, because if you think of them as the first thing that changes when the environmental conditions change. So the lifespan of a normal animal might be years. Some microbes are turning over every 4 to 24 hours. So if they're responding to a particular set of environmental conditions, like changes in water quality or ocean warming or ocean acidification, we see that very fast at the microscopic level, much earlier than what we might see visible declines in the ecosystem health. So I've studied microbes from the tropics to the poles. I did my PhD at James Cook University, and that was looking at the microbial interactions between coral reef sponges and microbes. So a coral reef sponge, about half of the weight of the actual animal is made up of these microscopic cells. Really, without the microbes, the sponge can't survive. So after finishing my PhD, I actually wrote a grant application to work with the New Zealand Antarctic Division to go down to Antarctica, dive beneath the ice down there, and really try to use microbes as an indicator of the human impacts that were coming from the research stations down there. So that was Scott Base in the New Zealand Antarctic Division and also McMurdo Station in the US program. Diving under the ice was probably one of the most incredible experiences I've had in my life. I came from Townsville, which was about plus 35 degrees at the time, down to Scott Base, which was about minus 30. And then there's just incredible biodiversity down there. Most people would probably assume that not much can live beneath the ice in Antarctica. But there are sea spiders and Nemertian worms and incredible sponge gardens, soft corals, fish. So it's essentially like diving on a reef, only in Antarctica. So amazingly beautiful, not quite enough to forget how cold you are, but almost. So after finishing my postdoc, I went back to the Great Barrier Reef and I took on a position as a researcher at the Australian Institute of Marine Science, which is where I stayed for almost 20 years. And during that time, I was looking at the role of microbes in all different parts of ecosystem health, and also trying to understand whether we could harness these microbes to actually help some coral reef organisms adapt much faster to climate change. There was actually a fairly logical transition between the Antarctic space and the Great Barrier Reef, because both of those ecosystems are essentially the fastest changing environments under climate change. We now have some global problems that really need science to be united. So probably one of my highest priorities in science as a leader is around integration of science. I think these big picture questions are so challenging, they can't be answered in single disciplines. So we really need to integrate data from chemistry and physics and biology. There's a lot of external partners that work very actively in Antarctica, and it's actually how can we all work together to be more than the sum of our parts.